Here we go, gig log number 9. Brought to the Sterling Centre in Rochester today. It's all Rochester, Chatham, Borstal really. But we've got a 21st birthday party, so it's all upstairs, leaving a little bit earlier, but there is a lift, hang on. I'll show you a bit of footage of the Sterling Centre, it's like a sports centre. I'll show you a bit of footage of that when we get there. So one guy, I think it was shout out to DJ Frostbite, he was asking about my dynamos, the scanners, 100 watt versions I've got. The compared to the others, I've seen the LED ones. To me, I wouldn't bother with the LED ones, mate. That's just my opinion. They're not bright enough, and they're not a gobo flower scanner. They're just basically an LED flower that on a pan and tilt mirror, which just doesn't give that effect. If you're looking for that sort of light, you want proper gobos with a gobo wheel. I mean, yes, they've only got a combined gobo and colour wheel. Some people don't like that. But you know, bear in mind, a few years back when I was first looking at these sort of lights, they were £500 a light, and you know, that was the cheapest thing you could get. Now you can pick these up for sort of £300 for a set of four, which is absolutely brilliant. Yes, when you're running them slow, the motors can be a little bit jerky, but for what you pay for them, in my opinion, they're brilliant. Bulbs, yeah, 100 watt 12 volt lamp. Only use myself, only using the Philips or Osram in them, a branded bulb. I've tried the OME, they're absolutely rubbish, they're dim as hell. But if you use a branded bulb in them, they're nice and bright, and the bulbs seem to last about a year, so they're not that bad on them at all, really. But yeah, I mean, the 250 watt ones, yeah, the bulbs could cost a bit more. I find the 250 watt 24 volt bulbs, the life of them, the life expectancy is much, much shorter. So yeah, they're a lot brighter, but you'll be paying a lot more out in bulbs. And the other thing I find is they're to light up. I mean, I get people, basically I can blind people with the 100 watt ones. I mean, all I do is sort of every once a month, I've got to make sure the optics are clean. Basically just clean all the mirrors and the lenses off with a duster, really. Cloth. Make sure they're clean. But yeah, we're off for tonight, 21st birthday party. Another light I saw, which I wouldn't recommend, is an LED one. It's the American DJ Tri-LED Aggressor. Now for the price, you can get that for like 90 quid, brand new, on somebody, eBay. So, but yeah, from the look of that, that looks to fill a lot of coverage on the floor for a good price light. Unlike the original, the old aggressors, you won't go through bulbs every 10 seconds because it's LED. And I say that I'm actually going for that light myself, and it was quite good. But the other thing is the LED lights. I mean, I've got the Impossi LED, which is the same as the Revo 3 and the Chevet View 3, but they just seem to be static dots that flash on and off. With the aggressor, it's actually the LEDs that you've actually, because I like the light, whether it be from a halogen bulb, whatever. My personal feelings is I like it to be moved by a motor, so you've got like a smooth movement as opposed to just like a flashing on and off. But enough about that. Hopefully we get I'll be able to get a full rig up in this set place tonight, so flood the place with UV lamp. But we'll have a look, so I'll give you a bit more footage when we get there. Coming up for the turning for Borstal, just by the Bridgewood roundabout. So over there to the left, that's where we gotta go. Here it is, up on the right here. There it is over there. I'm just gonna give you a quick walkthrough as I go up there to where we are. Entrance. Automatic doors. There's the lift, that's what we're gonna be using. So that's what I'll use in a minute, but I'm just carrying my bag up now.
through here. So there, that's where the lift comes out. We have to go through here. We're normally up over in that corner.